Nyase ansa na be kokote na apunu ati se bia obeye jaje na so odi asem no enkonko ba se bia ohun be bia ya uyemu ya odwe na so odi asem a wanhwe ya nokoka de nse ye ka ebe so odi pa so ma na busumi mienu a uyemu ya odwe pa na wadwa kwa so ma na busumi enkron na se mfie nyensa sanso na bia na atiti bi ofie na so de ba ebe ha dwe ntobia momode se na dwunu be da ho fine na oha bia enkokwo hye nso wo bra omudi asem.
The health and well-being of judges is an extremely important matter because judges are the heart of justice delivery in this country. When the judge is too sick to attend court, court does not sit. It's as simple as that. On that day when the judge was unable to sit, many things can go wrong for the people who were scheduled to come before the judge that day. That is how important the health and well-being of the judge is. And our constitution takes due cognizance of this imperative and makes the inability to perform the functions of a judge's office due to infirmity of body or mind a ground for removal of the judge from the bench. We therefore have to take very good care of our health, and it is also the duty of the institution of the judicial service to take very good care of the judges. It is the duty of the state to take very good care of the judiciary. Judgeship is a demanding work, requiring the delicate balancing of competing interests, applying the facts to the evidence adduced, and reaching a just conclusion according to law. As societies have become more complex, so have the crimes and civil disputes increased. This has undoubtedly put a greater strain and stress on the demands of our job. Factor is even more exacerbated when, through ineffective case management, backlog builds up and gets older and older, and that becomes a stress on the conscience, on the heart, and on the mind of the judge, leading to all kinds of cardiovascular and nervous problems. While we bear individual responsibility for devising creative ways of maintaining health and sanity in the face of the overwhelming challenges of our calling, it will be prudent that effective support systems are also established among judges that will provide the environment for us to overcome some of these, or at least soften some of these work-related pressures that undermine our health and well-being, and allow us to continue to thrive and perform optimally. Judicial service staff at whatever level, repeat, at whatever level, whether they are directors, senior or junior staff, they are also paid by the state to undertake their official duties. Any thank you must not go beyond the verbal thank you, God bless you. That should be all. That should be it. Anything else, whether it's a gift, whether it is money, engenders and fosters the spirit of entitlement, and the spirit of entitlement under such circumstances is actually an evil spirit, which feeds and entrenches corruption. So let's stop it.